All around, even huge old trees had fallen. Two coconut trees had fallen on the roof of the house. This was a blessing in disguise. See, two coconut trees were Prashant as well as Prashant's friend's family. Prashant's friend's family were sitting on the top of the house, on the roof of the house, and fortunately, the two coconut trees fallen on the roof, and in the coconut trees, the tender coconuts were available, and they were very hungry. So in the misfortune, they fortunately got the coconuts, and they survived themselves. They ate the coconuts. They took the coconuts. They drank the water of the coconut as well as they ate the coconut's soft part which is available inside of the coconut. So ultimately they got food fortunately because of the coconut trees fallen on their housetop, and they were on the top, so they got it because the tender coconuts from the trees kept the trapped family from starving in the several days that followed. For the next 2 days, Prashant sat huddled means in a group. For the next 2 days, Prashant sat huddled with his friend's family in the open on the rooftop. They froze in the cold and incessant means continuous, in the cold and continuous rain. The rain water washed away Prashant's tear. See, Prashant's friend's family, they were on the top. Next 2 days continuously raining was there. They all were in panic. Prashant was crying, but because of the raindrops, Prashant's face was washed away and his tears also washed away. He was crying, but it could not identified as because it was raining and it could not understand the Prashant's tears on his face. The only thought that flashed through his mind was whether his family had survived the fury of the super cyclone. Was he to be bereaved once again? During this moment, Prashant was very sad and he was thinking about his family and family members. He was thinking whether his family was alive or not. Because 7 years back, Prashant already had lost his mother. Prashant had already lost his mother 7 years back. So he was thinking, perhaps he had to lose once again his family members because of this cyclone. He was in panic. He was afraid of this. 2 days later, which seemed to Prashant like 2 years, the rain ceased and the rain water slowly began to recede. Recede means like stop, reduce. Prashant was determined to seek out his family. Seek out means find out. Prashant determined to find out his family without further delay. So 2 days passed on the same roof, on the same rooftop. So finally, after 2 days, when the gust of the water was slow as well as the rain reduced, Prashant thought to find out his family in his own village. His village was far away from that village. His विलेज वॉज फार अवे नियर अबाउट 18 किलोमीटर्स. हिज विलेज वॉज 18 किलोमीटर्स अवे फ्रॉम द विलेज वेर ही वॉज देन. बट द सिचुएशन वॉज स्टिल डेंजरस एंड हिज फ्रेंड्स फैमिली pleaded means requested with Prashant to stay back a little while longer, but Prashant knew he had to go. But after 2 days the rain was slow, but still the situation was quite critical, so that his friend's family means Prashant's friend's family requested him to stay back in the same place. But Prashant determined himself or Prashant determined that he had to go to find his family. He equipped himself with a long sturdy stick, so he went from there. And then started on his 18 kilometers expedition means journey back to his village through the Solen flood water. It was a journey he would never forget. He constantly had to use his stick to locate the road to determine where the water was most shallow. See students, in the next page the photo you can see, this is the actual scenery or this is the actual scene that Prashant was facing in the weather, cyclonic weather. See, after 2 days means on the third day Prashant came out from his family's rooftop and he decided to go 18 kilometers to his own village. Why? Because he wanted to find out his family, so that it was fully water, the village was filled with water, the road everywhere water and water and water. And because of that he took a long strong stick. With the help of that stick he found the shallow places. Shallow means the places which were not deep, the places which were not deep. So with the help of he found the road and he started his journey 18 kilometers to his village. At places it was waist deep and progress was slow. At several points he lost his road and had to swim. After some distance he was relieved to find two friends of his uncle who were also returning to their village. They decided to move ahead together. At first he was all alone and he started his journey for 18 kilometers. He was at difficulty at first. In some places he could not find the road, in some other places he found the deeper water level, so that he had to swim sometime, he had to walk. Means he had to swim, he had to walk as per the water level available in the around him. Okay, the water level, sometime the water level was very deep and sometime the water level was shallow, and as per the water level he had to walk sometime and sometime he had to swim. But after some time he found two people who were friends of his uncle. He found two other people and they were also returning to their village. So Prashant and the two other people decided टू मूव टूगेदर. ओके दे डिसाइडेड टू गो टूगेदर सो दैट दे कुड हेल्प इच अदर. एज दे वेडेड, वेडेड मीन्स लाइक वॉक्ड थ्रू वाटर. एज दे वेडेड थ्रू द वाटर दे सेंस दिस सॉरी द सीन्स वेयर विटनेस्ड ग्रू मोर एंड मोर मैकेबर. मैकेबर मीन्स लाइक डेडली डेंजरस. दे हैड टू पुश अवे मेनी ह्यूमन बॉडीज मैन वुमेन चिल्ड्रेन एंड कैरकेसेस. कैरकेसेस ऑफ डॉग्स. कैरकेसेस मीन्स डेड बॉडीज ऑफ एनिमल्स. कैरकेसेस ऑफ डॉग्स गोट्स एंड कैटल दैट द करेंट whipped against them as they moved ahead. So when Prashant and two more people were going to their village, they found devastated scenery because the dead bodies of the people, men, women, children, as well as the dead bodies of the animal, dogs, cattle, goats, buffaloes, cows, the dead bodies, both people as well as the animal, were floating on the water, and they had to push them away when they were coming in the way of their going. Okay, so It was dangerous as because they saw so many dead bodies and some house particles. Okay, they saw some house particles. So it was too dangerous. Next, in every village that they passed, they could barely see a house standing. They were passing through many many villages because they were going for 18 kilometers. So they were passing so many other villages and they could hardly see the house standing. Means almost all houses washed away. It was dangerous view. Prashant now wept out loud and long. He was so that his family could not have survived this catastrophe. Catastrophe means calamity, means natural disaster. Okay, catastrophe means natural disaster. So now Prashant started crying loudly. Why? Because of these dead bodies, he thought perhaps his family members also died. He thought whether so many other people died, so definitely his family members also died. He was in panic, and because of his panic he started shouting, he started crying out. Eventually Prashant reached his village Kalikura. So in this way finally Prashant reached his village. And what was the name of his village? Kalikura. His heart went cold. Where their home once stood, there were only remains. Remains means lifts of its roof. When he reached his house, he saw the house was not there. Some parts of the house were there. The roof was there and it was almost floating, and some other house accessories or house articles were there in the trees. Okay, see, some of their belongings were caught mangled. Mangled means like twisted. Twisted in the branches of tree just visible above dark water. So some of the house particles were seen which were tangled or mangled, twisted. Okay, twisted in the trees means the house was not there, it was washed away. Some particles only he found, as well as he did not see any member of his family. Young Prashant decided to go to the Red Cross shelter to look for his family. During the natural calamities, there was a NGO. NGO means non-government organization named Red Cross shelter. Red Cross shelter was an NGO that supported the people in its crisis. So he thought in this crisis, in that crisis, definitely Red Cross society started helping the people. So he thought to find out his family members visiting Red Cross shelter NGO. Among the first people he saw in the crowd was his maternal grandmother. Maternal grandmother means your mother's mother, means your nani. So when he reached Red Cross shelter, among the crowd, at first he found his maternal grandmother. Weak with hunger, she rushed to him, her hands outstretched, her eyes brimming means her eyes was full of tears. It was a miracle, but at the same time his maternal grandmother was happy. They had long given him up for dead. As Prashant was thinking perhaps his family members were dead, similarly his family members also were thinking perhaps Prashant died. So his maternal grandmother was very happy, and because of happiness her eyes was full of tears, and she rushed towards Prashant and hugged him. Okay, hugged him. Quickly word spread and his extended family gathered around him and hugged him tight in relief. Prashant anxiously scanned the motley battered group. His brother and sister and his uncle and aunts, they all seemed to be there. So finally Prashant found his all family members alive. He was very happy seeing his sister, brother, uncle, auntie, grandmother, everybody. So finally Prashant found his all family members. Even his family members ultimately found his son Prashant. So students, I think we have to complete up to here only. Okay, this page number 39. This is page number 39, and what we found, that Prashant finally found his family members were in Red Cross shelter, that is NGO.